Horse Tales is proudly brought to you by the South Carolina Department of Agriculture. South Carolina, a true leader in the equine industry.
Hey folks, welcome back to Angel in the Morning, part two. We're up here in Anderson County, and we are hop, skipping, and jump right over this big hill over here to Mike Kinsey's Start 'Em Right Ranch. But today, like I say, we come up here to get Angel, and lo and behold, the Anderson County Search and Rescue was putting on an obstacle challenge to benefit the South Carolina Horsemen's Council. Folks, as you can see in these rolling hills of Anderson County, we're looking forward to a great day. So let's get rolling along. All my life, I've been obsessed with horses. I was curious and wanted to see other people's love for their horses and their stories. I'm David Grant, the PD Cowboy, and along with some incredible horse owners, I want to share the story of horses and the people that have a passion for them.
When is the last time you traced your roots, not your family's roots? The roots of the food you eat, those roots should run deep, not from afar. Just like the legacy of farmers here in South Carolina.
Day in, day out, farmers from every corner of our state are carrying on the traditions of bringing locally grown food to your table. So choose food that's rooted right here. Choose certified SC grown. It's a matter of taste.
Don't go racing around looking for a car loan. At Anderson Brothers Bank, we take on all challenges to get you financed. Anderson Brothers Bank. Right car, right payment, right now.
Horse Tales, proudly brought to you by Anderson Brothers Bank, treating you like family since 1933. South Florence Feed and Seed, specializing in Neutrino feed products. South Florence Feed and Seed, locally owned and operated, where service and quality is our top priority.
Excellent.
Equestrian Images, committed to artistic excellence.
Southern States carefully crafts every bag of Legends horse feed with the highest quality ingredients available. The Legends Superior line of specially formulated feeds will help keep your horses happy, healthy, and in peak form. You and your horse have a special bond. To keep that bond everlasting, Legends Horse Feeds can accommodate every type of nutritional need a horse might have. Legends, redefining what horse feed should be. Visit your local Southern States dealer to see which Legends feed is best for your horse.
Farmers are always planning for higher yields, more diversity, expanding opportunities. Nationwide and your local agent want to help your farm last through the generations. As the number one farm insurer in the country, Nationwide can help you achieve your goals. We stand for you.
Folks, you're on now is Isla Hanks with Start 'Em Right. Folks, almost 8 or 9 months ago, we brought little Miss Angel up here to school.
Yeah.
Boot Angel camp. Had been at Brook Green Gardens for over a year, because we had an arrangement with Brook Green on a historical agreement for the Marsh Tacky to give. Most of the horses come back were pretty spoiled. So Isla, you've had her 8 months. Mm-hmm. Tell the folks what you've accomplished.
Yep. So we have rode pretty hard. She's come a long way. She still kind of has that mentality of, you know, life isn't fair and stuff like that. It's a little bit of baggage from just being, you know, loved on and petted and being able to take advantage of the children and adults that were petting her and stuff from when she was a baby. They carry that on for a long time as they grow up, and she'll carry it on for a little while, but she has came so far. She's so solid with going through terrain and going through, you know, the forest and the limbs and stuff and the muck. She's really a great version of a Marsh Tacky. I mean, I think she's going to really turn out nicely and over the course of a couple years.
Well, she, let's tell the folks, how did you start her off? I mean, she was very green. All she's been done is lead when we dropped her off, and she had a little attitude there. So you started her on the ground. Just explain how that went.
Yeah, so we started out with a lot of groundwork. We wanted to really get in her head that we are dominant and you're going to respect us and we're going to respect you. And so when we started the saddle training, And really, to be honest with you, she was all talk and no show. You know, she'd pin her ears and be real nasty with you, but she wouldn't do anything. You get up to her and she wouldn't bite you or anything like that. And so it was really kind of a little bit easy to, you know, get into her head that way and just take advantage of the fact that she really isn't going to do anything, and just discipline her attitude. And so when we started under saddle, we just ponied her down the trail real hard, and I mean, we just went at it, and it was almost like riding a drift car, you know, because she's sliding left and right, thinking the boogeyman's behind each bush and stuff. But you know, about 3 miles into it, and she's done for, and just thinking, I respect you, yes ma'am, no ma'am, do whatever you want. And so we just kind of kept it up at that. She is one that I have to ride very frequent to keep her. To keep her respectful. I leave her out in the pasture for 3 or 4 days, and we kind of got to do a little hard communicating the first 20 minutes or so of riding. But if you ride her every day, every other day, she's a pretty decent-minded horse.
When you first tacked her up, did she ever bow up like she wanted to buck a little bit or nothing? How did she resist you there?
She didn't buck with me. She has reared a couple times only because, and that was, she didn't do anything really in the beginning. It was almost like she was like, oh my gosh, I've been, you know, she was just, she thought she was in trouble or something, it seemed like. She didn't want to do anything wrong really, except she was just scared to death. You know, she was just real scared going down the trail. Once we started really getting into some crossing T's and dotting I's with training and stuff, that's, she started, you know, showing that baggage of life isn't fair, and I don't want you to take a hold of me, and I don't want to go left, I want to go over there with my buddies, and so at that point, that's when she started to show a little bit of that nasty attitude again, once she realized that it's not scary, and she can rebel a little bit, and so I've just been shutting that down as often as I can, always trying to set her up for success and not failure, because you got to keep in mind what they've been through before they get in your hands. You can't just, you know, expect the world out of them when they have baggage like this, when she was started out being loved on and stuff.
Well, folks, as you can see, she got a very unusual marking, kind of like a question mark. So, Isla, does she question you now?
Oh, I don't know. She don't want no piece of this. Yeah.
Well, I tell you, y'all really look good out there together.
Thank you.
The coloration and everything. Well, okay, I want to invite and challenge you to come down hog hunting with me.
Okay.
How about that?
That'd be
that?
Great. That'd be awesome.
And
I think she'll be great for that.
We'll do
really
that.
Yeah.
And hopefully if we can time it and get you down there, we can actually put that on the show.
Awesome.
Well, you were mentored by a very respected horseman.
Mike Kinsey.
Wow. And I wish I'd met Mike when we were both younger, but I don't know if we could even talk to each other when we were younger.
Yeah.
We kind of full of ourselves.
Yeah.
So you kind of doing some things on your own now?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So tell us about that.
Well, I train, I tune and train up horses. I start horses. I do horse lessons, farm visits, trailer loading, you know, sessions, anything from the ground up at all. I do it.
And you'll travel?
Horses. I do travel.
Okay.
Yep. And it's just, you know, I just charge $1 per mile to travel, easy peasy. And then, you know, and so whatever it takes, whatever I'm doing once I get there is what we'll take care of.
Isla will travel, right?
Isla will travel.
So, and also I was reading, because I might need to be schooled. You do psychological, behavioral analysis or whatever? Yeah,
diagnostics.
Okay.
So if you got a horse, you know, you're in the horse market and I train off behavioral psychology. So I read, you know, the horse tells me and I tell the horse, we communicate. And so it's, you know, that horse is going around and acting all pissy. I can keep up with that. I can pretty much predict what the horse is going to do, anticipate it before it does it, as long as you are really in tune with your behavioral psychology and can pay attention to what the horse is doing. And so, yeah, if you're in the horse market and, you know, you're looking for a horse, you can bring it to us and we'll put it in the round pen. We'll put it through a couple little trials of something and some groundwork and stuff and really put it to the test to see, you know, how deep that attitude goes or how rock solid that horse is or how nicely minded and willing it is and things like that. So that's another thing that I also do.
Well, I'm sure some of you Marsh Tacky folks will want to get in touch with it. Mm-hmm. Now, is this the first Marsh Tacky? I thought you had another one at the barn when I was there. Is this the first one you've done?
This is the first one that I have done. We have, Stardom Right has had a Marsh Tacky a couple years ago.
Okay.
that I believe was about the same size and color of this one.
Okay.
And she turned out to be real flighty. She wasn't really started bad or anything. She was wrapped real tight. And so she just needed us to kind of calm her down a little bit. And it turned out to be very successful.
The folks, old PD Cowboys wrapped kind of tight, and I turned out okay. Isla, how can we get in touch with you?
My phone number is 864-933-6700, and my email is Isla@stardemright.com. You can look me up on Facebook, on my personal page, or the Stardom Right page. I'm also on there.
Well, Isla, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Angel. Folks, I'm back with Mike Kinsey. Mike, we're up here in Anderson County, so what's... Explain the event today.
Well, this is the obstacle course that we have out here is the one we use to qualify mounted search and rescue for the Anderson County Sheriff.
Okay.
So we've taken that and we've kind of split it up on paper so that we can put riders through it. And it's a jackpot competition that my organization donated the $200 for the jackpot. And it's a money-making activity for the South Carolina Horsemen's Council.
Okay.
We're trying not just to get money for them, but get more people entered as members and get more interest, because the more people we can get in the South Carolina Horsemen's Council, the better movement we can get to take care of horses and horsemen. And that's what the organization's all about, South Carolina Horsemen's Council.
Well, great. Well, Mike, so folks need to keep looking on Facebook mainly, or the website. There's going to be more of these coming down to you in the future, right?
York's got one going on. That's also benefiting South Carolina Horsemen's Council. And then in June 9th, we've got one going on. That's, again, it's a money maker, and it's to get more people as members, more people involved in South Carolina Horsemen's Council. Ours is also put on by the Sheriff's Mounted Search and Rescue.
And folks, I'm going to put a plug. South Carolina Horsemen's Council, the voice of the horse in South Carolina.
Thanks, Mike.
Thank you, David.
Yeah, man.
Horse Tales, proudly brought to you by Warren Coker, Coastal Bermuda Hay Farms, Olanta, South Carolina. Hey, and a whole lot more. South Carolina Horsemen's Council, the voice of the horse in South Carolina. Morrell Tire, Latta, South Carolina, working tirelessly to bring you the best service in the industry. Hey folks, got pecans to sell? See Warren Coker, Olanta, South Carolina.
At Anderson Brothers Bank, we have the right formula for your car loan. Doing loans the big banks won't, at rates finance companies don't. Get on the right track with the right car, the right payment, and get to the finish line in record time. Anderson Brothers Bank.
Running on bald tires? Is your air conditioning struggling? Checked your brakes recently? Come see Morrell Tire Service for all your auto service needs. Featuring a complete line of Michelin tires. From trucks to horse trailers and sports cars to first cars, Michelin is safe when new and safe when worn. Stop in and see why we are your trusted Michelin dealer and repair specialists. Morrell Tire, Latta, South Carolina.
Folks, joining us, Mike Kinsey with Stardom Right. Mike?
David?
Good to see you again. About 8 months ago, I dropped off an Angel package.
Yes, you did drop off a package.
And that package was, like I've been accused of, from my good friend, the cameraman, having ADD. So do horses have ADD?
I can't say they have ADD, but some horses have generic issues that are behavioral issues, and some horses have environmental issues. Some of them are quirky and jerky. Some of them will settle down and do the thing you need them to do and learn, and others, just like little kids, just keep resisting and resisting and resisting. And you think about it, a horse always has a judgment of like a five-year-old child. They never really get past that. Most of them don't get past it. So it's always a bit of a struggle.
Well, like I say, with Angel, she was very well taken care of when I had her out of Brook Range, but she was very spoiled and brought her into where she was saying, I don't want to do any of this. I like you, but I don't want to do it. So you want to expound on some things Isla talked about, behavioral with Angel?
You know, both of us saw the same thing when we started. She was like that spoiled child that lives down the street. I'm not doing that. I ain't doing that. I ain't doing that. Mm-hmm. And so we had to be fairly firm with her, and sometimes we had to have some pretty sharp corrections. You are doing it. But it's not about us winning the battle. It's about making sure she doesn't win the battle.
Right.
We can adjust our battle a bit. And a lot of that with Angel was just making sure she didn't get away with some of those ugly things that she thought she ought to be able to do, like the biting and the kicking.
Right.
She's pretty much past that now. She understands that's not the right thing. But you get her out here to ride her, and in a ride environment, I mean, this little filly will side pass, and she'll back, and she'll do all sorts of things. And then you get an environment like today where there's a lot of people, a lot of horses around here. It's kind of like, I'm going to show you I don't have to do this stuff. And so it takes a pretty experienced person like Isla to understand what's going on and to bring her along and how to motivate her and recognize when she might be frightened and have all the patience in the world and recognize when she's flipping you that I'm number one with a different finger, and twist that finger a little bit and get after for it. So it's really kind of tough, and it takes somebody that's more advanced trainer that understands the behavior end. Because if you use the wrong method, the horse gets worse. And so for us, the trick is not picking a method, it's recognizing what the horse needs.
Well, Isla was mentioning that she, like today, she's doing a demo. She's really keeping the little horse moving. What was the purpose of that? I know the horse didn't want to, she kept on moving to do that energy. What was?
Well, a couple reasons for it. One is, yeah, it. If you try to stop a horse, I can't make a horse stand still. I can't do it. Yeah. And I know that. So instead of making a horse stand still, I'm going to make that horse work. And anytime a horse doesn't want to do something, solution a lot of times is that four-lettered word. Can we say that? W-O-R-K, work. And you just keep them working to the point that they get where it's easier to do the right thing than it is to do the wrong thing. And so that's what Isla was doing. Instead of getting in that battle of a three-year-old child, I want you to stop. No, I'm not stopping. Well, we can't do that, but I can make you go over here and go over there and go over there. Our job as trainers at our level is not preventing problems, it's curing problems. And there's a whole psychology behind that. And a lot of times people have a hard time understanding that. And it takes me a year to 2 years to train a trainer to get past that. Well, I'm going to do that. Because the other aspect of that is don't try to make the horse do something, make the horse want to do something. Horse doesn't want to get on the trailer, don't make him get on the trailer. Make them work out there by the trailer, and if you're good at it, eventually they're going to get to the point of, let me just get on the trailer. So those two bits of philosophy, I see a lot of trainers struggle with. They don't understand that. And that's when you get somebody like Isla, one of my other senior intern trainers, they've grasped that and are successful with the horse. They set that horse up for success.
Well, Mike, I know you train literally thousands, and I know nobody can put you on the spot. But give me the good, bad, and ugly with this little Angel horse.
Well,
I know you won't hold back.
beating around the bush has never been my thing.
No.
she needs hard riding, and she needs consistent riding.
Okay.
But you never want to get in that battle of arguing with her with reins or anything else. You want to do something that you can do that she can do. Because anytime you find something that you can't get her to do, that's a battle she's won. And she'll take that battle to other things, getting in the trailer, putting on a bridle. She'll figure out other ways. So you can never lose a battle. You always have to be thinking, what's my cue? What's my correction? And what's the reward? And with a little guy like her, if you're not thinking of those things, she's thinking ahead of you. I mean, she is a thinking mare.
Yeah.
And that's not necessarily a good thing. sometimes you want an old warrior that just does his job.
Yeah.
And that's, she's young. And she's got this baggage that she picked up from being babied and thinking that she's special. So I'd say ride the heck out of her. And don't ever saddle her up and say, well, I got 20 minutes today, so I'm going to go ride her for 20 minutes. Don't ever do that. Look at your watch, say, I got 2 hours to ride today. You go out and ride her, and in 15 or 20 minutes she's doing good, stop. Get off, unsaddle her, kick her out. You reward success. But if you do that and she's giving you a hard time, then you got a couple hours to keep riding until you get success. And that's where I see a lot of folks do bad. They got 15, 20, 30 minutes to go mess with their horse. The horse just fusses all over the place. They end up rewarding the horse by turning them loose, and the horse wins that battle. So make sure you got time and ride the hair off of her.
Well, Mike, I want to add part two to start them right.
All
folks,
right.
It's finish them right. Thanks, Mike.
Horse Tales, proudly brought to you by Tribute Equine Nutrition, designed and improved by equine nutritionists. Now available locally at South Florence Feed and Seed. Nationwide, when the PD Cowboy rides, he rides with Nationwide on his side. South Carolina Department of Agriculture, promoting and nurturing agriculture in South Carolina.
All
I'm Aaron Wood, Assistant Commissioner for Agency Operations at South Carolina Department of Agriculture. A great stewardship program at SCDA is the Waste Pesticide Disposal Program, where homeowners, farmers, commercial, and non-commercial applicators can dispose of old, outdated, or unwanted pesticides. Last year, we collected over 75,000 pounds at 10 events across the state. Be on the lookout for a collection event near you.
Folks, joining now is good friend Greg Gorchowski, and folks, it's apparent he's a good friend that I took the time to learn to spell his name, Greg. Or pronounce his name, folks. As you know,
yeah, he can't spell it.
I can't spell. Folks, horse tails has been a journey for me. Greg and I have become friends because of horse tails. That's another story. But today, Greg, you drove all the way up from Charleston.
You said you'd buy me lunch. I said I'll come all the way up just for that.
Wow. So, first obstacle challenge, tell us about.
Well, this is, his barn name is Argento. He is an Egyptian Arabian, which there's less than 3% of the Arabians are Egyptian. This is the oldest breed in the history of the world, back to Solomon. Well, he's got quite the breeding, and he is quite the horse. He's bold and he's fun. He's been under saddle for about a year. Of course, he's playful and a little disrespectful, but he's a good boy.
So he danced like an Egyptian today?
Yeah, he danced like an Egyptian.
Well, you've been in the swamps with me, so I said I did like to say he was bold, so he did really well.
I think maybe he could pull a hog behind him.
You think so?
Yeah, you know, the Egyptian hog hunting horse.
Well, what did you do to kind of prepare him for today? Because I know you walked in very green. You didn't make it in time for the walkthrough. So yeah. How have you prepared him for today?
You know, I do as much as I can before I get on a horse. And I do the tarps and the noodles. And we've done a little bit of gun stuff together with you. And hey, you got a little manners here. So I try, and I take him through the swamp. He's probably the only Egyptian Arabian ever to walk through swamp, but he does it. So we had not prepared for this and some stuff he had not seen before, but I try to prepare him at home.
Well, I noticed that, especially went to the limbs and the bog and stuff like that. He perked his ears up, and he knew exactly what he's done. So I knew he had done that before.
Oh, yeah. He's a swamp donkey for sure.
Yeah. Well, I like to see an Arabian. I just thought the boldness and the agility and everything was really good.
Yeah. Yeah, it really was. He might even have some endurance potential in here. I'm not sure where his potential is going to go, but he's a good boy.
Well, I know the horseman you are, and the potential he has, y'all go afar.
We hope so.
What's this in your hand?
Well, you know, he actually got third place out of I don't know how many, but he did good. He did really good.
So that means I don't have to buy you supper?
No, I thought you started buying me, because this won't buy much of a supper.
Well, folks, I had to get my crowd up here. I thought he did a little better than third place. But you know what? They know you ain't from around here.
Yeah, that's true. I sound normal.
Greg, thank you, my friend.
Hey, thank you for having me, inviting me. I appreciate it.
Folks, what a great time up here today in Anderson County. The winner of the obstacle challenge was Mark McCarter. Mark, wasn't your first rodeo, was it?
No, sir.
Great job out there. And folks, he donated the money back. Big old caring heart there. Mark, we appreciate that.
Thanks, sir.
Folks, until next week, keep your reins low and your hands quiet. And God has blessed this great country of ours.